There are very few records of the Hungarian ancient history except two myths of the origins, so that they have to be taken as the first reference in order to understand their beginnings through their own oral traditions. These two accounts are the legend of the white stag and the legend of the true hawk. Both of them, surprisingly for an Eurasian people of the steppes, mention characters having biblical and ancient Mesopotamian names. Unlike other Asian or European myths, that may have some resemblances with the most ancient legends of the Middle East but usually with a completely different nomenclature. The Hungarian accounts keep the original names. The legend of the white stag ascribes the origin of the Hungarians to the merging of two peoples, Subartunes and Alans. Since the Alans, together with the Jezg and Roxlans, are classified as Massagetas in early records and as Sarmatians in later ones, henceforth the terms Alan, Jezg, Roxlan and Massageta will be mentioned as Sarmatian in order to make this essay more intelligible, avoiding synonymous or quasi-synonymous terms, unless specification is required. They are identified with the Moshki of the Assyrian Chronicles and Meshek of the Bible. This legend starts with Dana, that is undoubtedly the same as the Sumerian Edana of the city of Kish, Cush, and who is equivalent with the biblical Cush, the father of Nimrod. The Cushan Scythians also had an ancestor called Cushdana. The Sumerian Edana was the first mighty one on earth who wanted to visit heaven, and did. This story coincides with the biblical account concerning Nimrod, though it is feasible that Nimrod set up the construction of the Tower of Babel on behalf of his father, being coherent with the Babylonian myth in which the founder of Babylon was Bel, the father of Ninus, Nimrod, that was the first king. In the Hungarian account, the son of Dana is Amenrd or Nemir, Nimrod, who had twin sons called Mega and Una. Also Nimrod's wife, Anyuta/Bau, has similar names in the Hungarian version, Aneth/Boldogarszani. The Assyrian accounts refer that Nimrod had twin sons, one of whose names was Maga, confirming the Hungarian myth. The legend says that Una and Maga were pursuing a female stag that led them into a foreign land, and there she vanished without leaving any trace. The disappointed hunters, however, met their two sisters, princesses of the Sarmatians, kidnapped and married them, becoming the forefathers of the Huns and Magyars. The stag is also relevant in Scythian mythology. The role of Scythians will be considered afterwards. It is significant that in the Hungarian legend the sons of Mnrt/Nemir were hunters, and Nimrod in the Bible is described as a mighty hunter, Genesis 10:9. His Sumerian name, or better, his title, was Nimrshag, meaning Lord of the Panthers, which in Hungarian is translated Parduk Urezgi, conveying the same meaning of the Hebrew name quoted in the Bible, related with the word Nimra, that means panther, leopard, combined with the verb rad, that is, to subdue. Therefore, the first part of the Sumerian name resembles the Hebrew one, but the second component is definitely quite similar to Hungarian. It is relevant that Nimrod had to subdue panthers in order to become a mighty hunter. This title is often misinterpreted as he being a leopard hunter, because it was the most dangerous animal in those times. But the actual meaning is another. In fact, the lord or subduer of the panther implies that he was able to tame these animals in order to use them as a valuable aid in hunting other wild beasts. Indeed, also the kings and notables of Central Asia, from where the Hungarians departed towards Europe, trained the panthers to employ them in hunting. Panther skin has traditionally been the most precious garment among Hungarian kings and leaders, recalling the very fashion in which Nimrod himself was portrayed. The historian Josef Ben-Gurion Harco, also known as Josipan, thought that Mnrt was to be identified with the first Egyptian king Menes, later merged with the Mesopotamian Nimrod, and his wife Aneth with the Egyptian female deity Neith. The second account is the legend of the Trul Hawk, a mythical bird identical to the Sumerian Dugd, that is the emblem of both the house of Atla the Hun and the house of Rpd. This story is about Imsh, a Sumerian princess that was sterile until the Trul Hawk came down from heaven and gave her fertility. She was married to Jaek, the king of Scythians, of the lineage of Magog, in agreement with the Assyrian chronicles, that report Magog as the founder of the Scythian nation in northern Mesopotamia. Imsh conceived Almos, the same name of RPD's father, that was a descendant of Atla the Hun, and in her dream she saw her descent as a river flowing from her womb that was growing towards the west, passing over the mountains and from which a great golden tree arose, representing a royal lineage of kings ruling in a faraway land in the west. This story recalls the dream of the Mede king Istumegu, Astyages, concerning his daughter, from whose womb he saw spring a river that flooded the earth, and in a second dream he saw a grapevine growing from her womb that became a mighty tree that governed the continent. These dreams were interpreted as a royal line from his daughter's offspring that would have built an empire, though dethroning him. The parallelism between both legends is amazing. Indeed, there is a relationship between ancient Medes and Hungarians that will be exposed later in this essay. The characteristic aspect of this story that credits the actual Sumerian origin of Magyars is that Almos is described as dark complexion and black-eyed, namely, a Kushite. His name means dreamer, since according to the legend he was conceived after his mother's dream. Even though the most widely accepted hypothesis regarding the origin of Hungarians has been the Finno-Ugrian theory, promoted mainly by Austrians for political reasons, the fact that Hungarian legends have an indubitable Mesopotamian origin and that Magyar language has been proven essential to decipher Sumerian writings leads research in a different direction. Cuneiform writing was also found to be used by the Hungarians long before they entered the Carpathian Basin. However, language is only one of the elements to be considered, as there are others more relevant, like cultural features and spirituality of Hungarians, that show remarkable differences from Ugro-Finnic peoples and place them unexpectedly closer to ancient Middle Eastern, biblical peoples. A recurrent characteristic that is found throughout Hungarian history is the duality. Within multiplicity, there are always two main components assembled in such a way that they constitute a solid unity, complementary to each other like male/female, black/white, north/south, east/west, consisting in two ethnic unities that vary from one period to another, resulting in the complexity that has generated all the different approaches and theories about the origins. This duality, expressed in the first legend through the twins Una and Mega, figures of the most representative ancestors of modern Hungarians, namely Huns and Magyars, existed since the very beginning. The first pair were Sumerians and Scythians. Since there is an interdependence between both components, before going on dealing with the Sumerians and their evolution, it is necessary to consider the Scythians in order to have a comprehensive view of the whole picture.